Hi everybody, here's Christian from TeamworkCast.
And hi, this is Falko.
And this is a Netrunner with TeamworkCast. This is April 27th. The regional is in Osnabrück, top 8 playoffs, I guess is the term for this, right?
Yeah, indeed, it is. And we had a 32 team of players that started and was cut to 32 because they wanted to have a time frame for one day. And they set the Swiss rounds for 55 minutes and the cut rounds for 35. So they could say we are at the final end if the double elimination works its whole way at 8 o'clock.
Yeah. Yeah, they wanted to squeeze everything one day. And so on the left, we have now Frederick, who is playing the HB, Engineering the Future. On the right, we have Ddark, also Valdemar, playing the Chaos Theory.
The lovely Chaos Theory without a custom ID. Frederick plays a custom ID and he bought it from me. So we have to say to both players, Frederick is one of the best players in Germany in the moment, and yes. Valdemar was a surprise out of the head, a white rabbit from this tournament. And we see a cop turn blue certification. No, it's blue level clearance.
A green level clearance.
And that's my hand. It's not the finger, but it's my complete hand. And
we have to say that you've been the kind of like the judge for this tournament, one of the judges.
Yeah, the drunken judge, indeed.
And you were completely wasted at this point. Still trying to kind of like manage things, and people were kind of like, accepting this drunken guy just stumbling around and touching cards and speaking to people.
Indeed.
Anyways,
and there's a run on RD. Eight credits go to the bin for a loss of 3 credits on the runner side after he played a diesel on his first click. A nice play and a nice mat he plays on. The first
early
one.
Score from the Vetrovius here. Ooh, NAPD, but he cannot score the NAPD anymore. That total wolf was pretty good, but it didn't slow Ddark down too much. I mean, it prevented the score from the NAPD. That was good.
It was a why did he access two cards?
I think he ran twice.
Ah, okay.
Spending I would all assume his so, money. Yeah. Yeah. And we see another green level clearance here. That's nice. And another green level clearance. I guess he got all of his green level clearances on his hand.
But sorry, I'm stuck on the first turn because he can't run twice through the toy booth. Oh, what?
He ran on HQ.
Sorry. Are you still drunk? No. I'm not still drunk. Of course. Two accesses from HQ brought him 2 points and an NAPD. Okay. Yes. Green level clearance has a little bit of a recursion, he comes back into the game, into the meta game, in the NEH decks. Now he is played, and it's a great card, and in HB only, it's also a good card. So Jackson is on the field, the cop is on the pressure, and we see an ABT is drawn with a Jackson, so he will drop all the agendas, I think, into the bin, because Frederick plays a little bit of a classic Glacier deck.
Well, we see a Tobos here right there, and I think Tobos is still one of the best ice in the game. It's so super taxing.
There's a
and
run on Jackson to disturb you, and Frederick uses the Jackson to get three hidden cards back into R&D. I think those were the agendas, but it was a good move from both. Installed from Valdemar from prepaid. And draws card with public sympathy.
Quality time.
Quality time. Okay.
We also missed that an interesting splash here in Chaos Theory. Last time he played Day Job.
Oh, that's very interesting.
Mm-hmm. So we see another prepaid, and there is an Astrolabe here. So this is really great because, of course, we have to assume that Frederick will be creating scoring servers, and now Ddark will be drawing additional cards for those installs.
Of course, but that's a very fast game. Both are very good players, and I played both of them, Frederick in Swiss and Valdemar the game before this in the cut, and he just stomped me with his beautiful cop deck.
Well, it can't be the game before this because this is already kind of like the finale of the lower bracket.
Okay. Then sorry. one game before, I lost to him in the loser's bracket and was out of the game. Hedge wand from the side of the corp and install. He has now 11 monies and an install in front of this remote drawing one card for Astrolabe. Great play from Chaos Theory, of course. Let's look what does this runner do.
Valdemar is kind of looking a bit in a sad spot. He only has 3 credits. He does have the prepaid, so he can get out of this hole eventually. But he has no breakers installed whatsoever. He's kind of falling behind a bit. He has to, punch it, you know. And he does. He plays a sure gamble.
Sure gamble costs him only 3 monies. He has left and brings him to 9, and then run on the remote. And that's a ninja run. Ninja run is the best.
Ninja run. And then we have bronze.
Next bronze, code gate, now with strength 1 and 1 and 1 subroutine.
Test running. The third click. Test running. We have to assume this is going to be a code gate breaker, and it is indeed a torch.
Torch, but now, baby.
He won't be able to scavenge anymore. He doesn't have the clicks anymore.
Yeah, it goes back on his stack.
Yes,
perhaps he plays Eureka.
And then he gets through, and that is just an Adonis campaign. Frederick plays a very conservative game. He doesn't do any kind of like rush shenanigans. He's watchful about the shape of bullshit that can happen.
Yeah, and we have to say that Anak was not sad. Not so many Anak decks were in this tournament, so he could play his slow style and Operation Money all the way, plus Adonis. That's a great Glacier.
You played an Anak and you didn't do so well against Valdemar's deck.
Everybody knew I played the finger, and they played Tolbooz in front of HQ and such a shenanigans. That was not good.
Those Tolbooz. Yeah. Anyway, we see a draw with Diesel here, and then we see a retrieval run on Archives.
Ooh,
nice.
Another good splash. So,
there's a fam. Nice. And the fam is, what?
Why not on the Tolbooz?
That is crazy.
Okay. Perhaps he has a scavenge to get the fam marker on the Tolbooz later.
That is very possible. And we see
another finger.
Finger
from me.
And there is something. Oh yeah, he used those credits already to play the retrieval run, so he cannot use them again to play now the dirty laundry.
Yeah, yeah.
He has only 1 credit left, so this is a bit of a tough spot here right now.
Hey, it was a correct correction from me.
Yeah.
Great.
All right, getting a credit and then getting through that ice through the bronze, and another Adonis campaign. No.
Perfect. The early Jackson was very in the favor of the Corp, I think. And we see Caprice.
I really like the cool conservative play by Frederick here. He really makes the runner hurt himself economically to try to get on those servers.
Indeed. What's that hairy thing in the top left of the picture?
It's a sexy leg, clearly.
Okay.
it's a leg. It's you know, some fine legwork.
Oh, very good.
Legwork in HQ.
We are Archive with ice in front of it. Don't resing the Adonis at the start of the turn. Now the runner is in a very hard spot. He is 2-0 in front, but he has no economy running.
I wonder why Frederick decides not to res the Adonis. Does he fear that it might get trashed?
I don't know. I would have rest it because running that would cost the runner 1 action and 4 credits. That's also good.
On the other hand, kind of like this kind of like makes creates a situation where Ddark or Valdemar he cannot use his fem in a useful manner, and we see in discard of the torch there.
Okay, perhaps he has another way to get it back into game. Now the Adonis gets rest, and that's a good way. That's not a scoring remote, but an economy remote, and perhaps a Caprice will make it secure for the scoring.
I see another Tolbooz on the hand of Frederick.
Crazy big eyes. Mm. But that's a good stable situation in the moment. He can't get through to R&D without the scavenge or something else, and protecting R&D, that's a long game.
All right.
Another thing we have to say about this tournament was Ollie, the great guy, the TO of this tournament, did a very good job. just pairing up the opponents and pressure all the time. We had to have the time limit for the rounds. And he was a nice guy to everyone. We had good food and a great place to play. It was the Spieltraum in Osnabrück, I think.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah, a great city in the middle of Germany. So run on HQ and raising an Eli, giving two clicks for an access.
Yeah, very well, nice organized tournament. Very
another
short.
Jackson.
Oh, Jackson.
And he gets trashed. Right decision.
Yellow men have to die.
Mm. Indeed. In this situation, the Jackson had, would have given Frederick another time frame for setting up, so he has to go.
I still can't get over that Fen thing.
Okay. You would have put it on the toy boost to make pressure on Andy?
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Okay.
Because you are a shaper, and I don't know. It like doesn't seem like, especially when there's like a bronze ice. Jackson's everywhere.
Okay, that's a perfect start for Frederick. Torbus Eli
really doing well.
Yeah.
After those first turns, he kind of like recovers very quickly.
Yeah. Sweet Jackson in the game, and Sweet Jackson's already out in turn six, I think, from him. Mm. That's great. Can happen better. So, what would you do in this situation?
Oh man, very difficult. Probably have to set up my rig because this is going to be a long game, and eventually I see Frederick building up a scoring remote, and I kind of have to like. There has to be some solution for this Eli on HQ. There has to be some kind of solution to get into R&D. Yeah.
That was a dirty laundry on hand.
Oh,
and
yes,
he
that's
trashes.
A very good snipe here.
Yeah, nice. Spending two clicks to break the Eli, getting five monies.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did he take the five monies? I hope so.
He did, yeah.
Okay. And so three action for five monies and one access. That was
and
a good choice.
Running on the jacks.
Yeah, of course. That's just the turn you waste as a runner. And Valimar did his best out of that.
Yeah, he definitely does, but he's kind of like falling behind now. Like, there's still no kind of like real Rick.
There's
and,
another,
and, you know.
Yeah.
As I learned in the next regional, it's kind of like a spoiler, once you start running multiple times through an Eli with clicking, you are losing the game.
Yeah. It's just costing you time and resources.
Mm-hmm.
That's not good. How did you do in this tournament?
I did horribly. I won just one round.
Okay.
And that's it, like two games in the entire tournament.
Nah. That's not a good way.
The funny thing, I used the same decks on next tournament and it went flawlessly.
The meta shifted already.
I don't know. Yeah, clearly the meta shifted in my favor.
You didn't get better.
No. It can't be. Like, I'm always horrible. Anyways, we see a blue level clearance. And of course, now the...
Frederick has a restructure on hand. He has monies out
man,
of his
look
ears.
At this.
Nice.
And those beautiful little rows here.
Restructure.
Yeah, get more credits, Frederick.
Frederick is a very observant player. He plays like getting the money, waiting for the opponent, deciding what the opponent does for his next moves. I think he is a favorite for the German championship.
He certainly is. I mean, he was in a lot of the top eight in the regionals in Germany.
Yeah.
Always there. So this is really great. But again, I'm the player that really, really left an impression on everybody on this tournament was Valdemar on the right here. Not so much with maybe his Chaos Theory deck, but certainly with his HB deck. And I'm really sad that we just captured one game of that deck on camera.
He tries to make a test one? Yeah.
He does. He makes a test run, and that is a battering ram. That's a really cool solution for this Eli right now.
Yeah.
Something that you don't see in play these days. So again, like Valdemar has like this kink for getting all these old cards, like old classics, and making them work.
And making the splashes really count. In his card deck, he does it really, really good. So scavenge on the battering ram, good combination. Yeah.
And same old thing. Not using his assist breaker this turn.
Mm.
Doesn't assume that there is any genders on hand.
So he has two breakers out. Let's look if he works through to get some points. Frederick is a little bit slower in the build-up, but then there are four or six turns where he scores his points and just wins.
I mean, with this kind of like monetary advantage, like an Ash is going to be just brutal.
Yeah. Double install in the remote and one unrest eyes, one eyes costing Valdemar one money. He has now seven. A difficult solution or a difficult problem. No.
Yeah, I mean, we have to assume one of the guys, one of the ice is a code gate.
Yeah. Okay. Ah, and then install and assert action.
Install in advance.
Okay. Perhaps the NAPD. Yeah.
If the drunken Falko comes along and tries to clarify which card was installed when.
Exchange the order of the cards. Yes. That was my problem.
Yeah.
So just making clear to Valdemar, this was installed first, and he, yeah.
No, it was refreshing to see a tournament where, you know, the tournament judge kind of like covers around and clarifies things. That's nice.
Yeah. Scavenge?
Wow. Oh, the fam probably gets scavenged. No, what? What is happening?
Thing and, why? I don't know, test one, perhaps. And then
that was a same old thing on the test run, and now scavenging in the torch. So yeah, we have some good breakers here.
No, six monies, two prepaids,
and last diesel. Click is going to be a diesel. Yeah, setting up his rig really good, but probably giving Frederick the score here right now. We have to assume this is an NAPD though.
Yeah, I don't count the money of Frederick. He has a lot of.
Yeah, like there was no way he. Valdemar could have gotten in that server and scored an APD.
Yeah, and the one on the server would just cost Frederick some money, not all of his money, so it wouldn't be a problem for him.
Yeah. So instead he decides to go for a tempo play, instead he decides to set up
subsequent runs. Garrot is dropped.
Nice! love it!
So, mandatory draw from Frederick. And he set up very, very nicely. R&D is now with one unrest eye and one big eye is very secure. The scoring remote with an update and an unrest eye is very secure. He can decide if he wants to score this agenda. Yeah, he will do.
He does. But it was not an NAPD from what I saw.
It was an beta test.
Beta test.
Yeah. And will he use it?
No, he's not.
He's not. And he's installing an ice over R&D.
And then he just installs, yeah, like just protecting R&D. Clearly, he smells that Valdemar wants to get somewhere.
Perhaps.
And
make
he
us
thinks
eye.
That it might be RNG.
Yeah.
Also, he's kind of like communicating that there is no ice on HQ. So I don't know if it's a good idea for Frederick to do this legwork right now that he just wanted to do. But decides otherwise, he counts the clicks. All right. Yeah, that's
lucky
good.
Find.
Lucky find. Sweet.
For plus 8 monies. Nice.
And now then the legwork.
With a battering ram. Battering ram is on strength 3, so you have to pay 3.
Yeah, 3.
Okay. Let's look. I don't know what Frederick has on hand. He has a poker face like anybody else.
I don't think there's going to be an agenda. Oh, ooh, there is an agenda? What? Okay, I would have lost this game. That's why I'm never in the top 8.
So we are 4 for Valdemar and 2 for Frederick.
And very, very well done here.
Both have a great presence on the board.
Yeah.
So perhaps, I don't know, I think Frederick will play an Ichi 1.0. I saw it in his deck. But another sentry I didn't see out of Architect. So the FAM might be enough and those breakers will bring Valdemar through the game. Yes.
I mean, he discarded the Garrote. If he really wants to, he can get the Garrote back.
Yeah, but he would use one memory more. Because
but he has the memory because he's
no.
Theory.
Ah, Kerosene. Yeah.
And he has the Astrolabe, so he's indeed. At 6 memory at this point.
Yeah, perhaps he plays Magnus Opus or something else.
Magnus Opus? Magnus. I don't think he's playing Magnus Opus because he has the prepaid.
Yeah.
I would be surprised, but you know, so far we have a lot of surprises in this deck, so everything is possible. We see a Dirty Laundry on the archive, so let's see what happens now. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, the Ichi that we're talking about, right? No, it's
Architect.
It has an Architect, alright. That could be worse.
For accessing all the cards, it's another Adonis. Wow. A perfect draw from Frederick, we have to say.
I don't think we saw that was like a monetary plus in total for this
no,
run.
No, it wasn't.
But at least keeping Frederick honest.
Yeah.
I won once against Frederick. Once in my entire life.
Wow, that's nice.
Yeah, it was sheer luck, obviously.
But he has his lucky jacket on. So Frederick will win if he wears his jacket. Yeah. But what would you do now in the runner's position? Andy is very, very secure. The legwork brought you 2 points and the scoring remote just gets bigger and there's an upgrade. You don't know
You know what? The thing I'm going to do is I'm going to same old thing, scavenge the femme on the toll booth and run on R&D anyway.
Okay. Yeah. Perhaps a wiser decision. But you don't have multi-access in the moment.
Yeah, that's true. So maybe I have a maker's eye on hand.
Oh, that would be very nice. Yeah. I think R&D pressure is the way to go at the moment. And HQ is not secure. Frederick knows that. And you can play on R&D and the scoring mode.
Another way to do this is to try to defuse the scoring server. And I mean, even if there is just an Adonis campaign in there, it would pay off to trash the Ash that clearly must be in there.
Mm-hmm. But another Caprice? We saw toll booths.
That could also be. Trashing that Caprice would also be great. Oh, nice! The third prepaid voice pet, Savit.
Why do you play the three... Yeah, if he uses it now, no. He doesn't use it. So you have three pets out and you use only 2 monies. For me, it's in Karma theory. It's 2 monies just in the bin.
Ah, yeah. That's crazy. I know what you mean, yeah.
And Ash, it has to die.
Yeah, there's... Oh, nice. Snapping all those important upgrades. Really good for Waldemar here right now.
The third prepaid is, for me, just a waste of money for Chaos Theory.
Efficiency, la la la.
Yeah, come on. It's just a click and 2 money.
We saw situations where Waldemar was playing 2 events per turn.
Okay.
And of course, there's always like Lucky Find, which he already used, sadly, a couple of.
We can count from now on how often he uses all 3 prepaids.
You are one of those people who
No, I'm not. I'm just saying if you don't use the recurring credits, don't play it.
The game is called Netrunner, not Bean Counter.
Erbsenzähler, please. Yes. We have a really, really beautiful German word for it, Erbsenzähler. We're just talking shit because there's nothing happening. Both players are looking at their archives or stack. And yes, we have a corp placement on the board that's very, very efficient and very good.
Mm-hmm.
The scoring remote that's safe and gets stacked with an agenda and it wants twice.
So Ash being used and then to free up the server. That was an Ash insult on a scoring server. Now it has been replaced with an agenda and advanced twice. It could be anything. It could be an APD. That would be really bad. It could be a 5-3 agenda. That would be really, really bad.
Mm.
There is just no... It could be a Project Vitrovius.
Yeah, that he wants to overscoring it. Very nice. First click was wrong. And he uses...
See, now he's using all three.
Okay.
See?
Okay. Plus 1 money on this wheel. Okay, third click. What does he do? He has to get pressure on the corp.
The second click.
Third. First was walkout.
Oh, he drew. Oh, yeah, I'm confusing this. Okay, last click. Come on, dude. Gonna give the score? Oh, man, he's looking for some solutions.
I don't know which. Okay.
You are not Lila. You're not benefiting from those cooperation scores.
So... Sweet one.
It was a 5-3. Oh, nice. Heinous fragment. Oh, man. This puts Frederick at 5 points.
And what does a Heinous fragment do?
Each turn, I wonder if Frederick will remember this because I guess he's Frederick, so he will.
Yeah.
So each turn he can get a card from archives back into R&D.
Test one on.
Mm. What will he get?
Okay.
He's not doing test one, taking it back.
Uh-huh. A difficult situation for him. I don't know what he wants.
He's struggling, clearly. He really needs to get a hold of this game.
Yeah, Waldemar told me before this game that his corp turns or corp plays were always easy and always secure. and his runner game is more the struggle of a game.
I mean, you know, again, we've been playing Netrunner for all day, and Valdemar certainly was one of the guys who, and I know that feeling where it's like at the end of the day you go like, I just want to go home. I don't want to play Netrunner anymore. Please, my brain hurts.
There comes the garage.
Yeah.
Why?
Just running out the garage.
Why?
Yeah, not sure myself. Like, doesn't really give him an advantage.
Okay, he doesn't pay any money for it because this week recurring pays for the test one. But now,
yeah.
Valdemar, show us what's
not really a fan of this play here right now, but maybe he knows something that we don't know.
He draws a card.
He doesn't scavenge it?
Why?
I guess he already scavenged it.
Perhaps the second click was gone before I noticed it.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. This is weird. We have to go back into those tapes when I edit this game.
No, I was there. And if there was
Falco,
I would have noticed.
Yeah.
And he has the same on Sing Out and could just legwork again to put some pressure on. I don't understand situation.
Do you really think that Frederick has agendas on hand with just this one Eli?
Yeah, but you have to put the pressure on. He didn't run for three turns or four turns.
I mean, I guess in the last time it was the same situation and he did have an agenda there. So.
And legwork is just with five cards, you see three. It's the best play you can do. He doesn't run on RD. Yeah, you would account seven accounts. No more money is for Frederick.
When in doubt, account seven.
Yes, indeed. You
that's
have
a,
to
that's
play
that's a
three.
Criminal way.
What do you think about Geist?
I'm loving Geist.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
I'm just so happy every time criminals get something new.
Yeah.
because we've fallen on hard times.
Oh, the ash bag.
Okay. So we see an archive memories to get the ash back.
Shuffling
HQ. Nice, nice. Mm,
Frederick.
Even though it's complete. What? Upgrade in R&D. Whoa. Man.
Okay.
Frederick, like, thinking two steps ahead here. The R&D wasn't even contested. Still, he feels the need to protect even more. And we see, of course, Ddark getting the call from his mummy.
I wanted to say the same thing. Okay, I hope.
And you actually said it in the video.
I'm just an asshole. Okay, so two cards left in the stack of the runner. Yeah. That's not good. And we didn't see a lot of economy out of events. So the recurring credits from the prepaid didn't pay off, my opinion.
Oh,
legwork!
Yeah, so
he has another legwork on hand. Great.
This influence was spent in a funky way.
Mm-hmm. So paying three for the E-line and
we'll
accessing
three
cards. That could be the win because Frederick plays five threes.
Yeah. Could be.
Frederick.
Oh man, I don't like the idea of just putting the cards out there. I don't know why people do that.
Three ices, nice.
Lots
Mother
of
goddess.
Really nasty
really
ice
good.
You don't want to see in any case.
I hope the fourth card would be an agenda. That would be that great.
Although Mother Goddess and Victor 2.0 are not doing too much with Torch out.
No, indeed on. But it's just pushing the next eyes, buffer strengths that could be a jog or something else for Anax.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Samar Singh 4.
Yeah.
I think Lucky Find. That's three clicks. And what else?
There is. Ddark didn't do a lot of runs on R&D. I'm wondering why.
Two unrest eyes and a toll boost. You have to pay. With a torch, it's five monies, and you know that's an ash.
I still think he should have
used
one of the same old things to scavenge the Femme over on.
But earlier in the game, he should have run on R&D just for the single access.
Yeah, and restructure. Yeah, clearly Frederick is missing some more credits.
Just giving him the opponent a signal for I don't have agendas on my hand. I'm just waiting for the agenda.
And just waiting for the draw.
Yeah.
And clearly, I mean, Ddark has to establish some kind of form of R&D lock if he wants to take this game home, because the first agenda Frederick will draw on his hand will get into the scoring server, and what happens then?
I think
another legwork.
Yeah.
using another round of using his third prepaid voice pad.
Just putting it in my face. Ah, there's a Levi in hand.
Levi. Oh, that's good.
Okay. So mandatory? No. It's a draw for an action. Hedge more. More sure. Monies, of course.
And then discarding.
And then discarding. I hope the Sir Jackson got shuffled back then to R&D. But, Frederick, he does it all the time. He's just a silent, good player, concentrating on all the things.
Does roll an R&D, finally. And Charles and Ichi.
So costing him 5 with a Garrot, if he wants to pay off a Trace subroutine.
Oh, he does not. The Trace goes through.
Okay.
He gets a tag.
Oh. Should have taken so brain damage also.
That's an Eli. Yeah, lots of retaxing.
With a battering ram.
Calculating how expensive this entire run will be. 3 for the Eli and...
not 3 for the Eli.
And 5 for the
Tolbus. 3 for the Eli and 5 for the Tolbus. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So 8 in total.
That's expensive, but you should have done it earlier.
Yeah, but and then that's we see Ash. So that's interesting now because Valdemar still has a lot of credits. So if Frederick wants to make this Ash count, he wants to use the Ash to keep him out, he would have to pay like a lot of money.
That's just taxing the runner. Yeah, forcing Lexus. That's good.
Let's see what he says.
Well played.
He's really checking how much money he else needs.
Mm-hmm. Of course. And 4.
He stays at 4.
Yeah. So he would have pay 3, nay 4. Chaos Sirius only 1, 0 link.
Oh no, he does put 2 in there.
Hmm.
So the Ash is trashed.
Okay, interesting. A lot of money on Frederick's side. Valdemar just thinking about playing now the Levy or something else.
I don't know if Levy is a good choice right now. It will create such a scoring opportunity. Don't play the Levy. All right. Same old thing. Using the same old thing for...
What?
Sure gamble.
Okay. Why?
Because he uses his third prepaid voice pad again.
Okay. Valdemar, yeah, you're a great guy, I know that. But just was scorching me. 4 eyes in front of the scoring
moves,
right, 1
and
upgrade.
We see the play that might win this game. We don't know yet, install and nothing else.
But I don't think that's a scoring window. 17 monies on the runner side, all the breakers out. Wow.
And that's a problem now. If Valdemar runs this and it's not an agenda, this will be very expensive for him. Oh, there is one advance. It is, actually.
Okay.
It is.
Wow.
Putting everything on that card.
That's a great move. And...
What?
What?
Yeah. He did have the Maker's Eye. I told you.
Yeah, he did. But why don't you run on the remote?
Well, I guess he first wants to see... he could win from this, you know? Just doesn't bother.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, he invested the money to get rid of the Ash. I think it's a good idea to follow up on this investment.
There are 9 points out of a game and 2 points in the remote. 11 points. And you see 3 cards. Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Nothing.
Score?
What?
What is the wrong score? Not something he wanted to see.
And now he can't run on the remote.
Yeah, 4 credits is not a lot. Last click.
I would have run on.
No, is this last click or is it first click?
It was last click is now spending 3.
And then we see the score of NAPD.
What?
Yeah, and it's GG. A bit of confusion here, but yes. We see a score of an NPD. Yeah, do you think he did had? Oh, that was an Nisei in the scoring server.
Yeah.
I think that was a very safe play by Frederick because it was an NAPD and a Nisei there. I mean, even if Frederick, if Ddark would have gotten in there and scored an NAP, and trashed the Nisei, he still would have to pay such a huge amount of money and wouldn't win the game.
Yeah, indeed, it was a safe play, but you have to run on this remote because next time it's a win.
Especially that Hugh could have gotten to run one of the eyes for one credit, so that was kind of like a big opportunity for him to get in there, at least making Frederick rest the eyes.
Yeah. I think that was an error.
Yeah, I think so too. I think we saw Valdemar kind of like losing steam at the end a little bit.
Of course. It could have been the win with a three-point agenda or something else, but no. Not that way.
He gave himself good chances. I mean, if you have encountered a three-point agenda on the final Maker's Eye, that would have been just game.
But a turn or two before setting up the rig and getting the monies to get the pressure up with the legworks would have been the better way, in my opinion. And an error was, again, the setting of the counter not in front of Andy from the farm.
Yeah, definitely. I think so. Yeah, like he could have saved so much money by farming the toll booth there
and keep the pressure up.
Yeah, definitely. 5 credits for that single scavenge.
Yeah.
All right, Falko.
Thank you for having me, and as always, we are patrons and we love you.
Oh man, yeah, you are one of my patrons, Falko. So if you or dear listeners want to join our Patreon campaign, it is at patreon.com/hacktheplanet. And if you join us, you will support the good stuff that we're doing here, and of course you will also get some exclusive access to some additional content.
Indeed.
Get more of
naked
those Netrunner
pictures from
videos.
Christian.
Yeah, and of course Falko and us together, and the finger goes into places, you know.
Stop it. You're making me blush.
Anyway, Falko, you are also doing a podcast yourself.
I'm doing a podcast. In the moment, I'm doing the Meta Arena in German and the Fifth Click in English. And I have an interview with Ian Birdsdale in the pipeline.
But, oh, man.
Yeah,
oh, so excited.
I have,
so excited.
No free time. But I will try to set it up and bring you some listening excitement.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Sweet, sweet. I'm looking forward to this very much. And I hope you will join me on our next video when we will comment on the finale from this region.
Ooh, of course. I was there.
Yeah. All right. So we see each other in the next video. And until then, we will hack the planet.
Hack the planet.
Shut up and get in the car.
Shit on me.